Hey everybody, Hoosier Jedi here with another review for you. This time I'm talking episode 1 of season 8 of Arrow, Starling City. And here we get to see our little adventure with Oliver on Earth 2 in its counterpart in Star City's counterpart there, which is still called Starling City. All in all, this is a pretty good episode. There are just a couple minor flaws. First things first, still don't care about what's going on in the future, so I'm not going to say anything more about that. The other major flaw here in this episode is they kind of had previously established that Robert Queen was the Arrow on Earth 2, and that he had been publicly unmasked, which kind of foreshadowed what ultimately happened to Oliver. But he's never even mentioned. And then somehow Adrian Chase has seemingly taken up his mantle and is going by the Hood. Okay, the idea of Adrian Chase being Oliver's heroic counterpart on that Earth, where, again, Oliver is supposed to be dead on this Earth, is certainly an interesting twist. I like how he even got to throw Prometheus's "I'm 10 steps ahead of you" line in Chase's face, but Chase doesn't quite get it. And he's just sort of like, has like that really intense Oliver mode, and that's his only emotional setting, which didn't really work for me very well. It seemed like kind of a waste of the actor, who, as we know, can do a lot of stuff. He's a good actor. I kind of wish they'd given him more to play with. But yeah, so apparently Oliver is, for the moment, acting as an agent of the Monitor, and is trying to get these dwarf star particles, so presumably to get together some kind of technology that might be able to save the day. The Monitor has been known to use agents to fulfill his goals. The Anti-Monitor has been known to use agents to fulfill his goals, so it looks like Oliver is at least, that's part of the deal that he made. I did get a good kick out of Earth 1 Diggle ending up there on Earth 2, and screwing with Oliver's head a little bit. I mean, there are a lot of callbacks to the first season of Arrow in this episode. And it all worked out, I think, quite nicely. I ultimately really do like that point where Oliver and Dick have that conversation, and Oliver's like, you know, look at how things are on this Earth. You know, my mom is still alive. And then Dick has to point out, well, yeah, but your sister is dead, and two of your people who are our closest friends are evil on this Earth. And yeah, that was pretty cool seeing, you know, Oliver beat down Earth 2 Renee and Diana, who are on that world scumbags. That was pretty satisfying. And then he just sort of just looks at them and was like, yeah, you didn't have a very good teacher on this Earth. I mean, Tommy turning out to be the Dark Archer, no surprise whatsoever. And as people have pointed out, it's kind of ridiculous that Oliver would just assume that it's Malcolm Merlyn, despite the fact that he's already noticed how much different this world is. He has experience with alternate Earths and things being really crazy and different. But no, he's just like, it's Malcolm. Then again, Malcolm is a little bit of a sore spot for Oliver. So you can kind of see why, like, he would just sort of assume Malcolm Merlyn is the cause of the problem here, because Malcolm Merlyn has been the cause of so very, very many problems in Oliver's life. So yes, Oliver is not thinking very clearly on that point, but it's interesting. I did like that, like, the whole Batman mask thing. It's just, it doesn't really make any sense. Why would Oliver have some sort of a grudge against Batman? I mean, I guess the CW, now that they have Batwoman as a show and have much more free hand to play around with the Batman mythos. I mean, Adrian Chase name drops Bruce Wayne, except that he's reciting word for word something that Sherlock Holmes said. Once you have eliminated the impossible, whatever you have left, however improbable, must be the truth. Okay, that's a famous Sherlock Holmes line, which of course Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. But Chase attributes it to Bruce Wayne. And it's like, okay, Batman exists in the Arrowverse. We've known that since last season when Oliver name-dropped Bruce Wayne. Again, I think the CW is going a little nuts with this, but then again, Batwoman is only on its second episode. This is really kind of what they're they're setting up to sort of take Arrow's place. The Star City 2040 show, I don't believe is confirmed. It's just sort of something they're toying around with, but a sort of more gritty Arrowverse show. Well, again, that's probably what they're going to be setting Batwoman up to be, and it certainly looks like that so far. So, okay, I can't really blame them for doubling down, making sure that we understand, yes, Batman is a thing in this universe, but still, a little heavy-handed. So I did like that ultimately Oliver was able to reason with Tommy. I mean, this does sort of show that it was really only the Earth 53 Tommy who really became someone truly irredeemable, where he was Prometheus. Interesting twist of what happened here on Earth 2. And I did like how it kind of shows up at the end, you know, the crisis wave destroys Earth 2. He sees Renee and Diana die. He sees his mom die. He sees Tommy die again. This means like this is like the third time Oliver has watched some version of Tommy Merlin die. And yeah, I mean, how cool would it have been if he could have saved Tommy too? I was happy that they did save Black Siren. She has grown on me as a character. This does sort of raise the question of what happened to Harry Wells and Jesse Quick. But I think that those two would have probably, well, at least Jesse Quick, I'm sure, probably would have had the ability to escape to a different reality, and that we'll find out where she is. Like, okay, maybe something crazy happened and she escaped, but she got trapped on a different Earth. I don't think she's scheduled to appear during the crisis, but we can always sort of like, oh yeah, Jesse's trapped on a different Earth. She wasn't able to participate, and then we'll find out what happened to her later on, sometime down the road. All in all, yeah, it's a good episode. I'm very intrigued for what they're going to be doing this season on the show, because it looks like they're really going to be playing around with things going very, very differently than what we're used to on a show like Arrow. And yeah, that kind of really covers everything I got to say there. So until next time, guys, thanks for dropping by the channel. Until next time, take care and have a good one.